up people's spiritual life and how to motivate people to serve God.
Tujja kulaba ngeri ki esobola okuzimba abantu mu kuyimirira n'okuweereza n'okuweereza Mukama mu mwoyo.
So this is for the pastors, the teachers, and also for everyone.
Bino njja kubanga amanyi bonna tukatadde ku basumba, abakadde b'amakanisa, n'amume n'abali wano.
So you motivate yourself to love God and serve God, and motivate other people to love God and serve God.
Olina okwezimba mwecho, okwezamu amanyi, okuweereza Mukama, n'okizimba ne mubalala, nabo ne baweereza Mukama.
Now you need to also write down the points and the Bible verses.
Wano oyina okukwata ekalamu yo n'ekitabo n'owandiika ebintu bino byengenda okubasomesa. Waliwo ensonga enkulu ze tugenda okusomako, waliwo ensonga enkulu ze tugenda okusomako, waliwo n'ebyawandiikibwa nabyo bye tugenda okubasomesako.
Okay. Now, so the point is how to build up people's spiritual life and the motivation to serve God.
Ngeri ki gye tusobola okuzimbamu abantu mu ngeri ey'omwoyo n'omukuweereza Mukama.
Many Christians are lazy. Many Christians just want to come to church and get some help. Maybe they like their friends. Maybe they want some help from the people or the pastor. And they think that if I get some help, get something from other people, then it's for my benefit. Now it's truly for our benefit. But we don't stop there. Because if we stop there, actually we won't get more blessings from God. Okay? Now I have this idea presented like a house. Like a house.
And
the roof of the house, the top of the house is the first point. Now I will tell you these 5 points. The top of the house is everything is in God's hand and no one can run away from Him. Now, do you believe that everything is in God's hand? Can you run away from the eyes of God?
No.
Now, but many people think they are smarter than God. They think that when I come to church and just get what I want, and then I make use of God. But actually, God sees our heart. God knows your motivation. And we cannot run away from God. And then on the right hand side on top is when we love God and obey God, God is, you know, God will bless us. And then down below, serving God will bring rewards from God. And then on the left hand side, if we live in sin and don't have a good relationship with God, there will be destruction. And when we don't serve God, also there is destruction. When we don't serve God, there is also destruction. Now, so everything is in God's hand and no one can run away from His eyes. And when you love God and obey Him, you'll be blessed. When you serve God, God will reward you. On the left hand side, we don't have a good relationship with God and we sin, there is destruction. When we don't serve God, also there's destruction. It's so very simple. Which side do you want to be? Which side? This side? This side? The first side, the second side? This side, first side, or the left, second side? Which side? Okay, tell them to respond. Which side you want?
Yeah, this side.
Okay, now.
Okay,
because we know that everything is in God's hand. All the blessings are in God's hand. Our life is in God's hand. When God likes you, He can give you all kinds of blessings. And He'll use your life greatly. And He'll bless your life greatly. So it's very natural to go on this side. But how come people still go on the other side? They don't want to pray, they don't want to obey, they don't want to serve.
Why?
They go on the other side because they think they are smarter than God. They think, I just get some blessings from God, and then, but I don't want to serve God. I don't want to give anything for God. And they think that they might escape the eyes of God. Let me ask you, do you obey God in every area of your life? Do you really want to have a close relationship with Him? Do you really want to serve Him? Don't move forward, because then you're getting closer to the camera.
Okay.
So, but you know, not all Christians have this motivation. Now for me, I know everything is in God's hand. Because I have so many miracles happen to me. I know God is blessing me. Like this sister said that she saw the vision that something, you know, a guest speaker is coming, and then she came. This is one of the many miracles I have encountered. So I know God sees what I'm doing. And I want to follow Him totally. Okay, now we look at the Bible verses now to support
it.
First, the roof. The roof. Everything is in God's hand, and no one can run away from Him.
Now,
please look for the Bible verse before you write it down so that it will help him. Okay? Psalm 24:1. The earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it.
Zaburi Abidimunya, Urinirusoka, Awenino Soma, Chawanikibetu. And see Yamukama, no good Grakwayo. And so now, Nago Abazitram.
Amen.
Okay. So what it says is everything in the earth, on the earth, belongs to the Lord. And the world and all who live in it, that means all the people, are in God's hand. We are in God's hand. Do you know that the big ship called Titanic? Do you know the big ship called Titanic? Have you heard of it? How many of you have heard of it?
Titanic?
Okay. The Titanic, at that time, was built a very big and strong ship.
Titanic, and
some people said this, even God cannot sink that ship. That even God cannot sink the ship. When God heard that, God was not happy. Now this ship has many segments because they think if one segment is destroyed, it's broken, the other segments can still keep the ship floating. But God
wanted
to show them that, you know, nobody can say something like that. And then on his first trip of this ship, the people were very excited about the first trip of this ship. And the people were having fun in the ship. But the ship hit an iceberg and it sank. Now in Hong Kong, among the Chinese, there is a one man called Bruce Lee. Have you heard of Bruce Lee? How many of you heard of Bruce Lee?
Bruce Lee?
Bruce Lee, how many of you heard?
Bruce Lee, yeah.
Bruce Lee. How many of you have heard of him?
Bruce Lee.
He's a man of Kung Fu. Kung Fu. And he has this 1-inch strength. 1-inch strength.
Inch?
1-inch. 1-inch. He said, if I'm just, my hand is 1-inch from you, and when it hits, that person will be knocked over. Now, in his movies were very famous. Because when he kicked, he was very powerful, very fast. And in one of his movies, it's called The Game of Death. So death is like a game. And Bruce Lee was very proud. One time I knew a Christian man who knows Bruce Lee. And then he said one time he met Bruce Lee years after, you know, they knew each other when they were young. And years later he saw Bruce Lee again. And then they tried Kung Fu on each other. And then Bruce Lee showed him by one kick. That man threw away is far away. And then this Christian man said to him, you know, about Jesus. And Bruce Lee said, you know, I don't need Jesus. That he thinks of himself very strong. But when he was doing this movie, The Game of Death,
Naibu yali akola filmu yayo yomuzanyo kwa walumbe.
He died before he finished the movie.
Yafanga tana mara na filmu yayo kuzanya.
Now at that time I was, you know, one day I went on the street and I saw the newspaper said that please take the crying baby outside.
Abana abanangi mutuyambe mubasirise twabati twagambi abana bakiri babere ko samuya.
Now and then I saw the you know the newspaper said Bruce Lee died suddenly.
Naraba ko echatwe unyisa mugwange wafe twarabe mpapura za maulire ku macharu acharumu nge mpapura zwanikibwa mte Bruce Lee afude orumbe orwambagirawo.
I was totally surprised.
Chatwe unyisa nyone twe unya Bruce Lee afuda atya.
A few days ago I saw him on TV.
Enako zaita ni tulumura bako ku TV.
And he was very proud. But when God took away his life, he could do nothing. When God took away his life, he could do nothing. So the first point is, everything is in God's hand. Our life is in God's hand. Now some Christians, they commit adultery. They said it's a lot of fun. I enjoy it. I'll ask God to forgive me later. But God hates adultery. We cannot run away from Him. And if this person gets AIDS, HIV, he's going to die. Now many people in this country die from HIV.
Give me the water.
And they thought they just have sex and have fun. But they cannot run away from the eyes of God. Okay, now the next verse. Revelation 2:23. Okay, the second part, 2:23. Then all the churches will know that I am he who searches hearts and minds, and I will repay each one of you according to your deeds. You just translate from the last part. Okay. Did you read it already? The second part of verse 23. Okay. So God searches our hearts and minds. Right now when you sit here, God sees your heart. Whether you have in your heart, yes, I want to follow God, I want to love God. Or in your heart you say, I'm not interested. I just want to think about my life. God sees your heart. When you have a heart to bless people, God sees your heart. You know, when I believe in Jesus in 1970, when I heard that there are many proofs that God is real, that the Bible is the Word of God, I said, this is a wonderful news. And I studied the evidence to be sure that God is real. And And then I said, there are so many people in the world who don't know Jesus. I want to tell more people about Jesus. And I said to God, in a short time after I was converted, I said to God, if you want to use me, I want to be a pastor. And I witnessed to many people after I became a Christian. So God has given me the heart to love Him and to love people. When God saw my heart, He opened a way for me to study. You know, I tell you, my family was very poor because my father gambled a lot. My father gambled a lot. Gambled. Gambled. Do you know gamble? That you want to get some money, you play cards or other things, and then you want to get some money. And sometimes in my home, when I was young, I ate rice that has mold on it. Mold, you know, that it's bad rice.
Rotten rice.
Rotten rice. When I started to work when I was a teenager, I bought some clothing for myself. But then one day my father could take my clothing to sell, so he will get some money to gamble. That's how I grew up. But when I believe in Jesus, I said, Jesus is wonderful. And I want to serve God and I want to tell more people about Jesus. And Jesus knew that. He opened a way. He opened the way for me to go overseas to study. And I have one bachelor degree in Bible college and two master degree in seminary in theology.
Aina degree esoka mu byamasomo ga Bible era ina degree biri za masters ebaita masters mu bya theology obwe byokumanya katona nokutegera katona kusingawo.
Now my family could never afford that.
Makagafe gari gasobola kunkorera kino.
And I could not have the money to do that.
Nanginze kasare chikoze sandi chisobode.
But God saw my heart and He provided for me. Some people just offer that to me. So I want to say, if you love God and follow God, God sees your heart and He will bless you. Now, glory to God. So if every day you say, Lord, I love you, I want to serve you, I want to bless people, and God will bless your life. Okay. Now the right side of the house. The right side of the house. Following and obeying Jesus will bring blessings. Matthew 6:33. Seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you. You can. Can you focus?
Matthew 6:33. tunonyereza obwakabaka bwe n'obutuukirivu bwe ebirala byonna biritugoberera oba birituweebwa.
So when you seek the kingdom of God and want more people to enter the kingdom of God to be
saved, bononya obwakabaka bwa Katonda. Yes.
You have to re-say what he said because the recording cannot pick up. What did you say? What did you say?
He can read for us. Agabe what? Asatu musatu. Esura ya mukana asatu onyura asatu musatu. Naye musoke munonya obwakabaka bwe n'obutuukirivu bwe era ebyo byonna biribongerwako.
Okay. Now seeking the kingdom of God means I want more people to enter the kingdom of God.
Okunonyo obwakabaka bwa Katonda kitegeeza nti okubanga n'emmeyo oyayanda okuba nti n'abantu bangi bayingire mu bwakabaka.
I want to tell more people about Jesus.
Ogamba nti nze njagala ntegeeza abantu bangi bonna bajjewo eri Katonda.
That's the first meaning.
Ekyo kye amakulu g'ekigambo ekyo agasooka.
And the second meaning is the kingdom of God is where God is the king.
Ekyokubiri kitegeeza nti obukamu bwa Katonda kwokukimanyira ddala nti Katonda ye kabaka.
In your heart you say, God is my king, I obey him in every way.
N'ogamba nti Katonda ye kabaka era mugondera.
So whatever the Lord tells us to do, we'll obey.
Kyonna ky'angamba okukola nina okumugondera.
That's seeking God's kingdom in our heart.
Okunoonya Katonda mutima gwo.
And also seeking God's kingdom in our home.
Okunoonya obukama obwakabaka bwa Katonda mu maka gaffe.
That God rules over our home.
Ne Katonda n'afugira ddala mu maka gaffe.
And seeking God's kingdom in the church.
N'okunoonya obwakabaka bwa Katonda mu kanisa.
That the church is full of love and care and evangelism.
Ekanisa ejjula okwagala, ejjula okuba nga abantu baagalira ddala okuweereza Mukama.
When you seek God's kingdom and his righteousness means to obey him.
Kitegeeza nti okunoonya obwakabaka bwa Katonda n'obutuukirivu bwe kw'okumugondera.
All these things will be added to you.
Ebirala byonna birijja buzzi bikugoberera.
All these things you need.
Ebyo byonna bye weetaaga.
Will be added to you.
Bijja kwongedwako.
So you will not be in short of things.
Tojja kubeera awo n'obeera mu bwetaavu.
Like now I can go to different countries.
Nga kati nsobola okugenda mu mawanga ag'enjawulo.
Because God is providing for me.
Obanga Mukama angabirira nga bwe kisoboka.
So I go to different countries to bless people.
Ntambudde mawanga mangi nga mpeereza abantu omukisa.
And God gave me good teachings.
Mukama n'ampa eky'okuyigiriza ekirungi.
And I thank God for all this.
Nebaza Mukama olw'ebyo byonna.
It's not because I'm good.
Si kuba nti nze ndi mulungi.
It's God who chose me when I was weak.
Nze Mukama yandoona nga ndi munafu.
You know, God chose me when I was sinful.
Nze Mukama yandoona nga nkyali mwonoonyi.
And I thank God for that.
Naye ekyo nkyebalize Mukama.
So I hope that in your heart, you know, many people just think of money, woman or man or children, and a reputation and a house.
Nze kimanyi waliwo abantu abangi abalowooza ku maka, abalowooza ku baana baabwe, abalowooza ku bintu byabwe, ku maali zaabwe, ennyumba ne buli kimu.
I hope you always think of God and then all these things will be added to you.
Nze nandiyagadde tulowooze Katonda n'obutuukirivu bwe ebirala byonna agambye bijja kutwongerwako.
Hallelujah. And Psalm 34:10.
Zaburi asatu munya olunyirirwe kumi.
The lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing.
Zaburi asatu munya olunyirirwe kumi. Mandisomyewo mu Bible awo y'Oluganda naddala tutegeererera bulungi. Nzenja. Zaburi asatu munya ayatuuse we asome. Satu munya olw'ekumi no mbeere nga mbiteekamu amaanyi okunoonya mangu Bayibuli. Zaburi asatu munya ayatuuse watusomere. Zaburi asatu munya olunyiriri lw'ekumi
agambe bwati nti obwana bw'empologoma bubulwa ne bulumwa enjala naye abanoonya Mukama tebaawulwenga kintu kirungi kyonna.
Amen.
Okay. Yeah. When it says here, even a lion, sometimes they don't have food and they get angry.
They get hungry.
The lion is very powerful, right? Very strong. But they can get weak and hungry.
Mm-hmm.
But those who seek the Lord will lack no good thing.
Mm-hmm.
When you seek God, He'll bless you with different things. Let me ask you, how many of you have experienced God's blessing in your life? Raise your hand. Raise your hand if you have experienced blessings from God. Then you've seen how God blessed you. Now, do you see this come from that you, because you love God, so God give you all these blessings? You know, God blesses us even when we are weak. But when we love God more, we can see more blessings. Okay, and John 15:5. I'm the vine and you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. Can you just... Don't wait, you know, it's too long. You just interpret. Just interpret. Can you? Okay.
Agabe what? Turi mu yokane sura ya 15.
Urugo 5.
Eh. Nze muzabibu mwe matabi. Abera munze nange muye. Oyo abale bibala bingi. Kubanga watalize temuli ko chemuiza ukola.
So when we Jesus is divine, if we stay in him and he in us, he will bless us.
Yes, ye muzabibu we tubera muye ajja kutuomkisa.
We'll bear much fruit.
Tujja kubera nebibala bingi.
So if you do this all day long, thank you Jesus, I love you Jesus, I love you.
Mukama nkwetaga, mukama nkwebaza.
Your life, you have more fruit.
Oh, bulamu bwo obera nebibala bingi.
That you have more and more blessing and strength. But if we don't pray, we don't have strength. Now some people think of praying like some more work. But actually praying is living in God's presence. And you'll be strengthened. So every day you say, Lord, the Lord loves me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. I love Jesus. Do you feel comfort? Do you feel comfort when you do that?
Oh.
Now when you relax yourself and say, Jesus loves me, I love Jesus, you feel comfortable, you feel good, and your life will change. So that's from God's presence. So when we have a good relationship with God, there will always be blessings. And then, down below the house is, serving God will bring reward.
Okay.
Okay.
Mark 9:41.
Truly I tell you, anyone who gives you a cup of water in my name because you belong to the Messiah or the Christ will certainly not lose their reward. So, you can just paraphrase. You know, anyone give you a cup of water,
Because
you belong to Jesus Christ,
you will
not lose the reward.
That means God
will reward you. Now, Jesus did not say, you bring a person to Jesus and I'll reward you.
Because
to bring a person to Jesus is
not easy.
Jesus make it easy for us.
Even when we give
a cup of cold water because he's a Christian, we won't lose our reward.
Let
me ask you, can you give a cup of cold water to
people? Is it easy, right? So
are you willing to do it?
Are
you willing to be nice to
people? And kind
to people? To be kind to people
and
pray for them
and
help them. So if you can do one cup of cold water,
you
can do more for God
and God will
give you rewards
and
bless your whole life.
So now
I train you how to lay hands on
people. And
then when you do it,
and
help people to believe in Jesus and love Jesus,
you
can start to serve God and bring people to Jesus.
And
God is very happy and he will reward you.
Is
it hard to serve God?
Is
it hard to serve God?
Chigumo kuwele za mukama?
No.
Aguza. Chigumo kuwele za mukama?
No. Now let me ask you this question.
Kambabuza ye chibuzo chino.
Now sometimes you receive, when you were a little kid, when you go to school, maybe you receive a little gift like a pencil. Have you received gifts like that?
Lumumba tuchari bato, tuagena na kusomero, nebatuwa yoku birabo, bukalamo, butabo. Na maari mchifunyeko, waliyo funyeko, chirabo chonango, munda kuwade kuchirabo.
Have you received little gifts?
Waliyo ya funyeko akarabo kona.
Now when you go to heaven, when you go to heaven, when you go to heaven, does Jesus give you a pencil? Give you a little apple for reward?
Does
Jesus just give you a little gift? Does Jesus give you just a little gift? A little reward?
Does
Jesus, when you serve God, does he just give you a little gift?
He will
give you big gifts.
And
the Bible said that in 1 Corinthians chapter
15. When one
day we go to heaven, some people are like stars and some are like the moon and some are like the sun.
And
one star is different from another star. Some are brighter, some are not so bright. And Paul said, when you are raised from the dead, you'll be like that too. Some are like the sun, some are like the moon, some are like stars, different
stars.
So when you really love God and serve God, you're like the sun.
Is the
sun different from a star?
Is it
different from a star?
No.
So some people will be shining like the sun.
Now,
Also in Daniel, it's also said the righteous will shine like the sun forever. But some people say, what is that with the big light, you know? I don't have to be a big light, I can be a small light. But I'll tell you, that light is the glory of God. Now in Exodus chapter 33, Moses asked God to show him his glory. And then God answered, I will let my my mercy, my love pass in front of you. We thought the glory is just light. It's the love of God, it's the compassion of God, the mercy of God. So for people who really love the Lord, when they go to heaven, they'll be so filled with the love of God. All day long, they'll be enjoying the love of God. Now everyone who goes to heaven will enjoy the love of God. But there is a degree. Now, in the book of Revelation, it talks about different groups of people in heaven. Now, in one place, it says there is 144,000 people who follow the Lamb, Jesus, anywhere he goes. And these people don't have blemish.
And
they don't lie, and they don't, that they are pure. So there are people in heaven who are very close to Jesus. Do you want to be like that? If you say, Lord, you are my everything. I love you, I follow you, and I serve you. And I want to bless everyone I see. I want to make the best use of my life. And I want to let people know how wonderful God's nature is. How beautiful he is, how loving he is. When you have this heart, and then you do it. And then when you do it, when you bless other people and serve God, that one day you receive a big reward in heaven.
Amen.
That you'll be so happy to receive. Now let me tell you, there is one person I pray for to revive her spiritual life and drove out demons from her. And then after I prayed for her, she started to hear from Jesus. And then Jesus took her to heaven many times too. Okay. And then one day Jesus showed her the book of her record, the record of all her good works. And she was happy to see it. But because I'm the person who had brought spiritual life revival to her, and she said, can I see the book a record of the reward of Pastor Yip. And Jesus told an angel to take that my book of reward to her.
Yesu naragira bamalaika ba balete batwaroyo bamulage mu kitabo kyebijukizo.
You know, when she described it to me, I said, Lord, I'm not worthy. I thank you for your grace to bless me and change me and give me the motivation to really serve you. She described the book like this. It is thick. It's covered with gold. And on top it says, my beloved son, and then my name. And when I heard that, I said, Lord, I'm not worthy. That God called me his beloved son. I'm very thankful to God. And I said, Lord, it's not me. It's not me. It's your gift. So I want to tell you, if you love God and serve God, and always see how beautiful God is, God is very happy with you, and He remembers all your good deeds, and He rewards you greatly. Do you want that?
Yeah.
You know, let me tell you, many of you are maybe are already 50 years old. Many of you are maybe 50 years old. Some are younger. But you have already lived half of your life. Are you satisfied if you keep living the same way? Or do you want to live a better life for God? Do you want your life just to be like this? Or better? And I hope you all want to live your life better. Okay, now the left side.
Okay,
the left side. The house, you know, we're talking about a house, remember the house? Living in sins will bring destruction and could lose salvation. Galatians 6:8. Whoever sows to please the flesh, from the flesh will reap destruction. So if we want to please our body, please our flesh, we can have destruction. Now I know that in this country there are Christians who commit adultery. Or maybe have a lot of anger. Or they hurt people. Or they don't love God. All this can bring destruction. You know, destruction is bad. I'm just using an illustration. Do you want Satan to come and bang you? Do you want Satan to come to you and hit you anytime he wants? When we sin, we are letting Satan come and bang us anytime he wants. Okay, and then John 5:14. The second part, the last part. Jesus said to the man who was healed from 38 years of sickness. And then Jesus said, see, you're well again. Stop sinning or something worse may happen to you. So Jesus says, stop sinning. If not, something worse, something bad will happen to you. We need to realize that sin is giving Satan a foothold. And we need to know that when Satan comes into our life, he comes to destroy and steal and, you know, and kill and destroy. He doesn't do good things. And when we sin, we're giving Satan the permission to come into our life. Now I really hate my sins in the past. Sometimes God let me remember the sins I've committed in the past. God let me remember some of the sins I've committed in the past. And every time I thought of these sins, I said to God, Lord, I hate these sins. I'm sorry I've committed these sins. I don't want to sin again. Because it would destroy my life. Now, can you imagine if I can bless so many people? If one day I commit a serious sin, people will not let me to come to the country. Wouldn't it be a pity? Would it be a pity, a bad thing? Would it be a bad thing? If you hear that Pastor Yip has committed something, you know, a serious sin, would it be a pity? You say, I want good things to continue to happen to Pastor Yip. Yip. Do you want good things to happen to you? Okay. Now, we come to the last part. Not serving God will also bring destruction. Not serving God can bring destruction. Not serving God. That even can lose salvation. Let me say, we are not saved by doing good. We are not saved by serving God. We are saved by grace through faith, trusting Jesus as our Savior. But when we are saved, then our faith will bear fruit. When you are saved, you want to bless people. When people don't want to bless people, there's something wrong with the faith. In Matthew 25, there are three parables of the last day, the judgment day, three parables. The second parable about three servants. There are three servants. One received 5 talents, one received 2 talents, and one. Let me finish. One received 1 talent, 5, 2, 1. And then one with the 5 talents and the 2 talents earned again 5 talents and 2 talents. And Jesus said, "You're good and faithful servants."
Yesu yagamba nti muri bawereza barungi.
But the one with one talent is buried in the ground. And Jesus said, "You are the wicked and lazy servant." And then he is cast out into the darkness. He is cast out, sent out to the darkness. Is the darkness heaven or not? Is the darkness heaven or not? It is not. It is not. It is hell. Because this person doesn't have faith, real faith in God. He received the spiritual gifts and buried the spiritual gifts. And then he sent to hell. Because there's something wrong with his faith. And then also the third parable about the sheep and the goats. And the sheep are the ones who have done good things to the little ones, that is to Jesus. But then the ones who did not do to one of these little ones, Jesus sent them to eternal punishment. Matthew 25, verse 26, 36, 35, and 46. Now, this first to the lazy servant. His master replied, "You wicked, lazy servant." And then 30, "And throw that voiceless servant outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of the teeth." Now you can say this. Can you say this? You're wicked and lazy servant.
Munzikiza. Ebweru walibera yo kukaba walibera yo. Eh? Wakwita? Gwebiki. Ndoza chetu.
Did you find it?
Aye Bible yo Uganda and chitu tugambye burungi.
Did you find it?
Wachifunye? Katusomere tukaveyo.
Okay, read verse 45, 46 now.
Ya soma anamu mukaga na anamusamu.
Okay, read 45, 46. It's Matthew 25.
Mumatayo abiri mutano anamukaga na musamu.
45 and 46. There it says that he will reply, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did not do for one of these little ones, you did not do it for me." Then they will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life.
Okay.
Okay, please read.
I got it right. Mazima kutamati ngabu wakola omu kuabo asika obuto temwa chikola anze nikakano nika nebano balitamu nebano baligenda mukubone de mukibonerezo ekitali kwao naye abatukirivu baligenda mu bulamu obutali kwao.
Amen.
Okay. 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 So these verses tell us that when people don't serve God, God doesn't like it. And if there is something wrong with their faith, they can go into eternal punishment. Are you afraid of eternal punishment? Are you afraid of it? I tell you, I'm afraid of it. But I don't serve God because of fear. I serve God because God is so good. So I want to keep telling people God is so wonderful. Okay, look at this house again. On top of the house. Everything is in God's hand and no one can run away from Him. And then loving and obeying God will bring blessings. And then serving God will bring rewards. And then on the left side, sinning and not have a good relationship with God will bring destruction. And not serving God can bring destruction. Are you all diligent to serve God? You know, you can start with just blessing the people, being nice to them, care about them, and tell people about Jesus, and pray for people, and God is very happy. Is that difficult? So which side do you want to be in? This side? The right hand side, right? And you will see blessings. How many of you love God and serve God, you find blessings? Please raise your hand. When you love God and serve God, you find blessings. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank God. Thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I hope you use this teaching to encourage people. Which is the best side to go to? Which is the best side to go to? Okay, let us stand up to pray now. Oh, hallelujah. What time is it now? 5 p.m. Oh, hallelujah. Everyone pray to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Everything is in your hand. Don't take pictures. Everything is in your hand. Everyone close your eyes. No one can run away from you. This you don't stop. No one can run away from your eyes. And God is happy with those who come to Him and repent of our sins and love God and serve God. Lord Jesus, move our heart. We pray for Uganda to bring revival to Uganda. We pray for our souls that you give us revival in our heart so that we have love for you, we have zeal for you, we have fire for you, that we have strength from you. Oh Lord Jesus. Help us not to be lazy servants. Help us not to be lazy in prayer. Help us to enjoy praying and enjoy loving God and enjoy serving God. Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We obey you, Jesus. Jesus is God. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are my God. You are my Savior. You are the King of Kings. I want to obey you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. It's blessed to follow you. Oh, Lord Jesus, revive our spiritual life. Revive our spiritual life. Help us not to be lazy. Help us to love you more. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.